after SpaceX made history when it reused a Falcon 9 rocket to orbit a telecommunications satellite from Cape Canaveral, Florida. On March 30, 2017, Sputnik asked Boris Katerjian, the designer of Russia's famous Rod 180 rocket engine, about the Rod's future use and the development of super heavy rocket boosters. What Elon Musk and his team did is a real breakthrough. The Soviet Union planned to use the same technology on the energy booster, but the project was eventually scrapped due to a lack of funding, Katerjian said. He added that even though the cost of SpaceX boosters remains prohibitively high, they will eventually cost less to build, and a switch from expendable rockets to reusable ones will ultimately make spaceflight cheaper. When asked whether reusable booster stages were also being developed in Russia, Boris Katerjian said that, if such a goal were set, Russian engineers would certainly be able to do this. These will differ from the projects we had 25 and 30 years ago, of course, and will be based on the very latest technology available today. However, with enough specialists and funding, it would take us 4 years tops to have the job done. He added that even after Americans design their own heavy rocket engine to replace the Rod 180s they have been buying from Russia since the 1990s, Russia would keep using them on its heavy and even super heavy launch vehicles. Our main advantage over the Americans is that we already have a successfully working rocket engine, which is the best around and will remain so in the foreseeable future, Katerjian emphasized. He added that Russia is currently developing the Angarad A5V super heavy rocket with an eye to ensuring the country's information security, promoting scientific research and space exploration beyond orbits we now reach. He said that a super heavy rocket is also needed to clean up the geostationary orbit of space junk and prevent asteroid threats. When asked about the need for a methane-powered rocket engine now being developed by the Energomash Association and SpaceX, Boris Katerjian said that Energomash was experimenting with methane decades ago, and in the late 1990s it even designed a methane-powered booster. Unfortunately, the lack of funding forced us to put it off till the later time, he added. Methane fuel is a very promising way to go, but it should initially be used in small quantities in the upper stages of a rocket, while oxygen kerosene remains the best first stage fuel we have today, Boris Katerjian told Sputnik. Meanwhile, the United Launch Alliance ULA, a joint venture of Lockheed Martin Space Systems and Boeing Defense, Space and Security, has placed an order for 11 Rod 180 rocket engines and plans to buy more in the future. The U.S. space program currently relies on Russian-made Rod 180 rocket engines to power the booster rockets that carry its astronauts up to the International Space Station ISS. Private companies, including SpaceX and Blue Origin, are developing rocket engines that could be used by the Pentagon in the future. In 2014, the U.S. Congress strictly limited future purchases of Russian Rod 180 engines at a time when it imposed economic sanctions on Russia. Legislators passed a law requiring the United States to develop a domestically produced next-generation rocket propulsion system by 2019 so as not to rely on the Rod 180s. However, in December 2015, the U.S. Congress passed the budget that includes a provision allowing the country to continue buying the Russian Rod 180 rocket engines